Welcome back to Let's Play a Tear of Vermillion Blind. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. What are we doing back here? Well, I wanted to see if we left, because it says south is Valkd. He doesn't let us go. Avin says, oops, I shouldn't leave the town. I have to find a soldier of the king's army and give the letter from Baron. So I'm assuming it would say the same over here. Just want to see. Says that's Dorks. Yep, he says the same thing. Okay, let's restore. I was just afraid we missed something. Okay, so we're loading this one. Okay. To recap, we took a monster cart with Mile and Amel. Bernard came up from behind. And Rutis tried to help us. And then Lord Belius appeared. I even tried to stop him, was knocked unconscious. Mile also then woke up, tried to stop him, and he was lost some blood, and then was fell unconscious, hopefully not killed. Lord Belius teleported Emel and Mile away, for whatever reason, I don't know why Mile. And then Avin woke up here. Oh yeah, and what do you call it, was here. Sage Gawain came, but he was too late, so I'm assuming he brought Avin here. Well, that's probably his voice saying, hi, you're awake. Oh, it's Oracle Callion. You've been sleeping for 3 days. Meanwhile, I treated you. For 3 days, says Avin. Is there any part that hurts? No, I'm fine. Thank you for treating me. Where is this, anyway? It's the Grand Cathedral of Valkd. This is the residential district for oracles. Wow, we're in Valkd. Valkd. The holy capital Valkd. I'm assuming it's pronounced that way. I remember. On the way to Valkd, our monster cart was attacked and... Where is Emel? How about Mile? I'm sorry, but I don't know any details. Please ask Sage. Sage? Sir Gawain, also known as the Sage of Power, he's an advisor of the Bardas Church. He's the one who brought you here, too. Gawain, says Avin. Yeah. Sage Gawain yelling, run, Avin! Back from the beginning, 8 years ago, from the beginning of the game. Avin yelling, Emel, Emel! Gawain drags him away. Because they're being attacked. Ah! Yells Avin. Uncle Gawain. He saved me again. Oh, good. If he came to save me, Emel and Mile must be safe too. Oracle Callion had a distressful look on his face. You should ask Sage about the details. Please come this way. If you go down these stairs, you will get to the chapel, the center of the Grand Cathedral. Sage and Priest are waiting. See you later, Nan. Hey, wait. Well, I have no choice but to go to the chapel. Emel and Mile might be there already. No, they're not. A strong voice says, so, there was no clue available. Voice of an old man says, I did everything possible, but I couldn't find a single witness. It's the same as it was in Cathedral. Gawain says, judging from the ill aura left behind, I guess Lord Belius himself showed up. The first time since the fall of Cathedral. A meek old man says, what an unlucky incident. I feel bad for those children. Oh, Avin. You seem okay. You were lucky that you were safe. Uncle Gawain. I can't believe you remembered my face. You're right. I'm Gawain who took you to Sir Lemurus. You've grown so big. I couldn't recognize you at first.
I heard that Sir Lemurus had passed away. I would like to express my condolences.
Well, is this Quar or whatever? And you are?
He's Supreme Priest Quar.
Quar?
I don't know how to say that. He succeeded Sir Asparius, who you also know.
Even says Quar.
You know, I had something I had to deliver to you. Sacred treasures, Cabessa and Karupo, right? I know it was rude, but I decided to take them when I was taking care of you. Thank you for bringing them to me.
It's all right. I delivered them on the opportunity to come to the Holy Capital. Anyways, where are Imel and Mile?
None of them are saying anything. What's wrong?
Please answer me. Avin, please listen to me and try to stay calm. They are not here.
Where are they then?
I see. There must be sightseeing in Valkd.
He really doesn't remember what was happening before it got knocked out?
They are brats for leaving me in bed while they go sightseeing.
Avin.
Avin, I know this is going to be hard to hear, but they were taken away by someone, probably by the Octum's apostles.
Haha, what are you talking about? That is really not funny. When I arrived at the scene, all that was left was you, unconscious, and a girl with black hair. And this.
Avin says it's a Miles Bell.
So this belonged to your friend. Then you should keep it to remember him.
Avin received Guardian Bell.
To remember him?
What do you mean, to remember him?
I'm really sorry. I wish I could arrive there a little sooner.
I'm asking you, what do you mean to remember him?
That bell was soaked into copious blood. Probably because of excessive bleeding?
Avin says, no way.
But I'm pretty sure that Imel is alive because she's very important to the Octum's apostles.
Please leave the rest to us. We won't fail to rescue your sister. This is the least I can do for you.
Avon's laughing. I don't believe you. I won't believe that they are gone.
You are telling me all lies.
Avin, I don't care if you blame us, or me, but do not deceive yourself. Sir Lemurus didn't raise you to be so weak. I can't help it. If I didn't think that way, I'll be ruined.
Avin?
Sir Gawain, we'd better leave him alone. He's hurt enough. It looks like he needs time to heal.
Imel, Mile, where am I supposed to go?
Back where you came from.
I'm very sorry. If only I had arrived earlier. Please, stop it. I can't think about anything. Avin, have a good rest. This cathedral is filled with peace and calmness. You should have a good rest.
I'll take responsibility to rescue Emel from the hand of the Octum's apostles. This is how I can redeem myself for involving you in this.
Okay. So where are we going now? Oh. Oh, it's an empty room? Wait. Oh, we can walk through here.
Oracle Gilliam says, I heard that the traitor, Lord Belius, showed up. It's been 8 years since the cathedral fell. He finally started his activity after being silent for so long. We won't be able to avoid a full-scale confrontation, I assume. We have set the defense networks double and triple in the Holy Capital, learning from the fall of Cathedral. It would be very difficult for even Lord Belius to break through.
Roan says, Ah, hello. You are Avin, right? I heard about you from Sir Quar.
Quar.
I can't get the hang of that word. My name is Roan. I'm getting my shelter at this Grand Cathedral. Well, are you alright? Are you hurt anywhere?
No.
Good. I was really worried. By the way, Avin, have you ever seen stained glass windows in a chapel? I heard that the form of Bardas is traced. When I see it, it calms down my mind.
I love the stained glass windows in the chapel. I think humans are wonderful because they can create such wonderful things.
Are you not human? He's talking like he's not human. Oh. Okay, this place is big. Oh, there's books! There be books.
Oracle Crystal says, This is the second reference room. Here you can find various information regarding the church. Please feel free to look around.
Oracle Cadfell says, The number of the books carried is less than the library in the cathedral, but I'm sure we have a larger number of important documents. But because we don't have any light books like novels, this place might not entertain ordinary people.
Alright, I'm gonna look at these. We're gonna have separate books of separate videos, of course, of these books. But I will read them here again as well. I can't even see where I am.
Books about history and geography line the shelves.
Oh. So we can't read all of them, at least.
Books about the interpretation of doctrines line the shelves. Maps and nautical tables.
But this one's nothing.
There's a book titled The Complete Works of the Monstrous Six, The Amorphous Ghost. Do you want to read it?
Yeah, definitely. That sounds awesome.
The family of Amorphous includes the genus of Sibyl and Pupiru.
Oh, so this is about the monsters we fight.
Sibyls are superior spell users and have a high ability of defense. Therefore, it's hard to handle them during the battles. Pupirus are resistant to weapon attacks. On the other hand, they are very fragile against spell attacks. Larvae and larvas, which belong to the Amorphous family, don't get affected by any physical attacks by swords and such. Moreover, both types of monsters are good at spells. If you encounter them in battle, you'll have a hard time. The Complete Works of the Monstrous Five, the Amphibians and Plants. Famous monsters in the family of amphibians are the genus of frogs such as silent toads, red fin, and blue horn. They are highly resistant to spells and their bodies are sturdy, but their speed is surprisingly slow. In the family of plant monsters, the genus of Mesthis are listed Mesthizoa, Mesthizel, as well as Mesthis. They are all strong against spells. Also, there are dangerous monsters which can use special spells like sleep, confusion, and paralysis.
Okay, so I guess here's one.
The complete works of the monsters, the flying monsters. There are three different genus in the flying monsters family, Scout, Bat, and Beaten. Among the genus of scouting birds, gorilla bird, attacking bird, as well as scouting bird are famous. They are a very agile type which attack with quick moves and retreat right away to recover. Scurvier bat and thin blood bat belong in the genus of bats.
Makes sense.
They live in caves and suck the blood of humans and other animals. Among the genus of beetons, rock-throwing monkey are popular as well as beetons. They have high offensive powers and are good at the spells, but they move slow. Hmm. The complete works of the monsters 2, the fish cephalopod monsters. Jawback and jaw orm are the typical type of fish in this family of fish. They are good at disturbing opponents with quick moves. Jaw orm is also skilled at the spell which decreases the enemy's speed. Many of the cephalopod monsters have high offensive ability. Gambler squid and prodigal squid have the characteristic of releasing electric shock. If you agitate prodigal squid carelessly, it may heighten its offensive ability. The genus of octopus includes tegos, eudora, and more. They not only have high spell powers, but also thrive on attacks. They are monsters which everyone has trouble dealing with.
Okay.
The complete works of the monsters 3, the crustacean monsters. Shell squilla, shell pagris, radical hermit crab, as well as superb crab, slay scissors, and iron arm crab belong to this family. Shell squilla, shell pagris, and radical hermit crabs have hard shells and use spells. However, their spell attacks are weak. On the other hand, superb crab, slay scissors, and iron arm crab shoot a fatal blow with their scissors. On the other hand, other abilities are extremely low. Hmm. The complete works of the monsters 4, the insect monsters. The genus of armored insects and of bees and mantis belong to this family. In the genus of armored insects, special armored beetle, armored poisonous beetle, and blue armored beetle are on the list. In general, they are quick and some use poison. Cluster bee, blue glass bee, and assist bee are listed in the bee genus. If they attack by themselves, their power is not high, but they often attack in great numbers. Among the genus of mantis, wind-cutting mantis, blue water mantis, and earth-shaking attacking mantis are famous. Each is good at distant attacks with kamaitachi, in addition to a certain degree of spells. Nothing here. What about here? The complete works of the monsters 7, dragons summon monsters. The dragon family is generally high in attacking power, especially good at breath attacks. You want to avoid them if you can. Rakuruta, Vidarda, and Velasis are the well-known dragon monsters. They habitate in caves. Summon monsters are called with the ancient sacred spells. Few people are sure of their existence, so not many details are known. And finally, the complete works of the monsters 8, the variety monsters. These variety monsters were produced through curses and the evil spells of humans. Karame, Zanzu, Avatar, Obis, and Hazaman belong to this family. Karame is a very quick monster, but it can't maintain its speed long. It's best to attack it when it's taking a rest. The genus of Zanzu is very dangerous because it blows itself up when driven into a corner. The monsters in the genus of Obis are poisonous and durable to spell attacks. Their offensive power is strong, too. The monsters in the genus of Hazaman are very unique. They can transfer in space. Also, they are good at dealing with spells.
Okay. I got 8 more books to read. Just like that. Oh, I talked to him. I don't even know where I came from. There's a bunch of people in here. Davis says, "Wow, what a splendid building. If I pray in such a place, I think I will receive a good benefit. I'm glad that I decided to come to the Holy Capital to pay a visit." Old Woman Rayo says, "I came from Guia to pay a visit to the Holy Capital. This is my second time to enter the Grand Cathedral. The first time was for my honeymoon with my late husband. I remember visiting the cathedral then, too. It would be a magnificent building more than this Grand Cathedral, but no one can enter after the big disaster. It's too bad that we can't go pay a visit." Butler Ronald says, "Ah, where art thou? She was just in the chapel praying till now. Please wait for me. I, Ronald, will not fail to find you." Huh. I wonder what he was looking for. Old Man Joy says, "Oh, if I remember right, we were on the same boat. We had adventurers escorted us safely to the Grand Cathedral. You all arrived quite late." I guess it was inappropriate. "I don't know what has happened to you, but please don't get discouraged." Patty says, "You know, he protected me from the monsters. So I told him I would marry him in return. He said yes, if I remember when I grow up. I love that adventurer." Is she talking about Mile also, I think? Oh, this place is huge. Oracle Tewam says, "You are the one who was carried in the other day, right? Is it okay to walk around?" Avin says, "Where are these stairs leading to?" "To the basement. What about that?" "Is it possible to go outside from the basement?" "What are you talking about? You need to rest more. I think you should go back to bed." "I think you should take more rest. You must be exhausted." No, we're not going downstairs yet. Alright, so there's more. Wow, I'm getting lost in this place. I'm done skulking back there. Holly says, "Let's study together. Miss Millel's class is a lot of fun." Prim says, "It's amazing that the king is friend of a dragon. I'm a little jealous." "He is? But it's okay, because I have Ruru." Meow? Meow meow. Purring. The kitten rubbed up against Avon's leg. "I have seen this cat somewhere. Ruru seems to like you. Please take care of him." "It's not my job to take care of him." Roya says, "I like the history class the best. Hearing the lecture makes me feel like being in the place." Or being in the place. Talim says, "My eyelids are so heavy. I can't tell this to Ms. Millel, but I would rather practice swordsmanship than study. My dream is to become an adventurer." "Hi, how are you? Anyone can attend this Sunday school. Please join with children if you have time. Today's lecture is about Milligan the First and Guardian Dragon Arvraheat." Oh, I remember that dragon. "I'm sorry, but I'm not in that kind of mood," says Avin. "Please come anytime, but please don't raise your voice."
"I'll raise my voice whenever I feel like it."
Oracle Aeolia says, "Are you by any chance Avin? I've heard about you. I'm sorry that you had to go through all of that."
I'm Sister Aeolia. I'm a guide of the Grand Cathedral.
You don't look good. Why don't you take a rest in this room? By the way, the girl with you is resting in the opposite side of the room from yours. Please go see her.
The girl with me? You're just talking about Rutis.
I've been in here.
Hello?
Chief Oracle Prockle says, "Oh hi, what's wrong? How may I help you?"
"Nothing in particular," says Avin.
"Something's bothering you? Please pray for Bardis at a time like this. You are able to speak with God through prayer."
"Oh, stop it. Praying won't make my wish come true."
"You could be right. However, prayer will be the light to shine on the darkness. Please be careful not to let the darkness of your heart get your feet carried away. It's immeasurable how deep the abyss is."
Is there a door here? No.
Instructor Gasuka says, "Oh, you are the one the sage brought. Are you feeling alright physically?"
Physically.
"These people are meditating. I'm sorry, but could you please leave? They are praying for Baroness."
Well, I guess you don't care that much if we're alright.
Kurasan says, "I came here to thank Bardas for a good quality of radish." "Don't you think I'm pretty religious?"
Nita says, "Did you come to pray to Bardas too?"
"No."
Mana says, "I came on a pilgrim with my daughter. I'm very happy to fulfill my long-lasting dream."
I think you mean pilgrimage.
I don't think you came on a pilgrim.
Actually, depending on how you imagine that, that might be disgusting.
Is this these people?
Oh, that's the same room.
Alright, so this is that library. And then this is with the one kid. Where did I even come in? From this stairs. Okay, but what about these stairs then?
Oracle Azari says, "The man in the next room is the great Oracle Avarice's follower. When he was in Benekwe, he used his authority as a substitute and threw his weight about. He looks low-spirited, but I can't sympathize with him at all."
Well, I'm back over here now.
Oracle Callion says, "Hi, Avin. Did you go see Sage?" Avin nodded silently. "Then you should take a rest now. You're not fully recovered yet. Or why don't you go see how your friend is doing?" "My friend?" "The wounds she's suffered by spells are healed, but she doesn't wake up because she must be exhausted. Please go see her. She's in the room directly opposite of yours." "I'll go make up a prescription." That goes back over there. So I think then she's in there. I think this is Avon's room. Yeah. So she's in here then, I guess. Oh no, this is... Oracle Runal says, "I can't believe that Mr. Avarice was arrested. Things were going so well for me, but I shouldn't have taken that man's side." Yeah, you're right about that. Alright, so maybe she's in here. Ah,